So next topic is fast frequency hopping spread spectrum. In this case, your hop rate RH is always greater than the symbol rate RS. Now you can see this is the block diagram of your MFSK transmitter. So binary data is there. Okay. So there is a binary data over here. Then you have MRE FSK modulator and the PN sequence is generated, given, fed to the frequency synthesizer. Then the MRE FSK modulated wave is multiplied with the frequency synthesizer output and it goes to band pass filter, and then you are getting the FH MFSK signal. Here this is the receiver of your BFH frequency FH MFSK. The received signal is then fed to your mixer, and the same PN code is used. And it is fed to frequency synthesizer, and we have a band pass filter, then we have MRE FSK detector, then again we are demodulation is happening here. After demodulation we are getting the binary data. In case of your direct spread spectrum technique, you were using BPSK modulation. In case of frequency hopping, FSK modulation is used, but we are using MRE FSK modulation. Now, in this case, what happens? In FH system, an FH tone of shortest duration is referred to as chip. Here, the chip rate RC is given by the same formula, max of RH, RS. So, here the chip rate is equal to hop rate, because in case of your fast frequency hopping, hop rate is greater than your symbol rate. So, RC becomes equals to RH. The advantage of fast FHSS is that before the jammer tries to complete reception of one symbol, the carrier frequency is changed. So it is very difficult for a jammer to detect the signal, or the detection becomes very difficult, because during one symbol, while sending one symbol, the carrier frequency is changed. But in case of your slow FHSS, when you are sent, multiple symbols are sent through a single frequency hop. But here only one symbol when you are sending, you are changing the carrier frequency constantly. So it is very difficult for an intruder to track the information if you go for fast FHSS, because the hop rate is here greater than the symbol rate. Then only one symbol is sent, and during the reception of one symbol, the carrier frequency is constantly changed. So detection becomes very difficult in case of your fast FHSS. Now, you can see the advantages of FHSS, fast FHSS. Okay, so the system bandwidth is very large, more secured than your direct sequence spread spectrum. It is more secured than slow hopping spread spectrum also. Okay, so it has a short acquisition time, the distance effect is less. Now you can see disadvantages is the frequency synthesizer is very complex. It is very complex to design such a frequency synthesizer where the hop rate is more than the symbol rate. Coherent demodulation is also not possible. So we have to go for non-coherent demodulation. Fast FHSS need error correction. So there may be possibility of error because the hopping is happening at a very faster rate. Okay. Now, there is a comparative analysis between your slow and fast FHSS. So you can see advantages of direct sequence spectrum. It is best. Okay, so noise, it is very prone to noise. Your DSSS is prone to noise, whereas your frequency hopping is not that prone to noise. Coherent demodulation can take place in your direct sequence spread spectrum. The generation of coded signal is very easy, and it can be done by a simple multiplication. Okay, so DSSS has best discrimination against multipath signals. And the disadvantages, it has long acquisition time and it has some near-far problem. Okay, the PN generator should generate sequence at high rates. It requires wide band channel with small phase distortion. All these disadvantages are overcome in frequency hopping. And out of slow frequency hopping and fast frequency hopping, fast frequency hopping is more secure, but it is more prone to noise. Thank you.